smallest of the three most popular islands in the Bay of Naples, Procida doesn't have the same number of attractions as Capri and Ischia, but it's also far less crowded than its larger neighbors. It's the ideal destination for those seeking a laid-back seaside vacation. Towns like the main port Marina Grande and Chiaiella have basic accommodations, restaurants serve simple meals of fresh fish or rabbit, and sandy beaches offer sunbathing and swimming. The Church of San Michele, with its painted domes depicting Saint Michael battling invasive Turks, offers a break from the sun as well as a glimpse of Procida's history. The smallest of the Aeolian Islands, located north of Sicily, Panaria is the darling of celebrities and jet-setters from all over the world. With a population of around 200, the largely undeveloped island has only a few hotels and rentals, which helps keep the island free of summer crowds. There are no cars on Panaria. Locals and tourists motor about on golf carts and electric-powered bikes. Most food is imported and expensive. In the evening, lamps and lanterns light up the night. Upscale visitors come to Panaria to swim, dive and sunbathe in privacy and to enjoy lazy strolls through the island's postcard-perfect villages. Ischia is the largest of the islands that dot the Bay of Naples on Italy's western coast. Sandy beaches and natural hot springs make the island a popular travel destination for weekend getaways for residents of Naples and for packaged European tours. Most of the island is mountainous, dominated by the 789-meter (2,589-foot) tall volcanic Mount Epomeo. Ischia has many attractions worth visiting, including the Giardini Ravino, a botanical garden located at Forio d'Ischia known for its extensive collection of cacti and succulents, the Castello Aragonese, a medieval castle built by Alfonso de Ragnona, and the Gerver Tower, a 15th-century fortress that's become a symbol for the island. Located off the northeast coast of the island of Sardinia, La Maddalena is the largest isle in the La Maddalena archipelago. Linked to its neighboring island of Caprera by a long causeway, the island can be reached by boat or by the ferries that run from Sardinia throughout the day and night. The pink-toned granite rock quarried near the town of La Maddalena, some of which was used in the construction of the Statue of Liberty, makes the village glow at sunset. The town is known for its smoldering nightlife too. A road circling the island brings visitors to La Maddalena's most popular beaches, Bassa Trinita and Spalmatorne, and passes by several abandoned military forts. Located closer to Tunisia than it is to Italy, Lampedusa is home to one of the world's most beautiful beaches, Rabat Beach. Situated on an islet on Lampedusa's southern coast, the heart-shaped beach can be reached by wading through the crystal-clear shallows. The protected island is one of the few spots in the Mediterranean where loggerhead sea turtles can safely lay their eggs. Conditions for snorkeling and diving are ideal on Lampedusa, and a tour by boat is the best way to find the perfect undersea location. One popular diving spot is around the submerged statue of Madonna del Mare, where divers can encounter octopus, groupers and sargo fish. Lipari is the largest of the seven volcanic isles that make up the Aeolian Islands off the coast of Sicily. Once famed for the black obsidian pulled from its volcanic earth, Lipari is best known today for its rugged landscape, pretty whitewashed towns and crystal clear blue water. Snorkeling, diving, boating and hiking are favorite activities on this scenic isle. Of the island's tourist destinations, the Aeolian Archaeological Museum is a must-see attraction. The museum houses an amazing collection of artifacts from the nearby Contrada Diana Necropolis, including thousands of sarcophagi perfectly preserved by volcanic ash from ancient eruptions. A part of the Tuscan archipelago off Italy's western coast, Elba is best known as a place of exile for Napoleon, and most people include a visit to his summer and winter homes while visiting the island. Italy's third-largest island boasts more than 150 beaches too, from wide stretches of sand to sheltered coves. The most popular beach destinations include the resort of Marina di Campo, the ultra-fine sand of Procchio and the dreamy blue waters of Vitobia. Hikes in the mountainous inland area are favorite activities too. Visitors have been known to come across gemstones, quartz and crystals on the slopes of mineral-rich Mount Kapan.